So we just drove about 100 meters. And as usual, I always forget something. So after 100 meters, we had to turn around. And I had to fetch my wallet with my driving license and visa card. Oh boy, we need your hope to live. Oh boy, you'll have so much to give. Oh boy, don't let it get you down. Ooh, baby, who would save the world? Not too late. Ooh, baby, who would save the world? The heroes hesitate. Too young to die.
Är maten bra, Elliot? Tummen upp. Inåtigt. Så hör ni. So we just came to the traditional mountain farm. It's called Selstali. It's extremely cozy up here. They got some animals, sheep, pigs, cows, duck, rabbits and chickens. They serve food and coffee and everything you need. It's just next to the mountain Gaustatoppen, where we hope we can get up tomorrow.
And here is the bacon factory.
So we have left Selstali, and on the road down to Rjukan, we stopped for a quick lunch. It's actually quite a view from here. And today's lunch is Elliot's choice. It's gonna be fried sausage. In 1810, there was a Norwegian that came here to measure the waterfall, and he used a barometer, and he actually found out that the waterfall was 271 meters high. So it must be the highest one in the whole world, they thought. But then they returned in the end of 1800, and they measured it again, and they found out that it was actually only 105 meters tall. So a slight difference. Känns det bra?
Ja.
You feeling good?
Ja.
Ja.
Kolla här. kör ni med två?
Ja, vi får använda vilken växel du vill.
So we reached the former heavy water plant in Rjukan. And they were, how many was it? 4 or 9 saboteurs entering in the site. And 5 of them went inside the production that is no longer here and blew up the whole factory. And then they fled for 500 kilometers over the mountains. It was in the middle of winter in February. With skis to Sweden. There was only one that entered Sweden and the other ones returned to Norway for new missions. And some of us carry water in a more traditional way than others. An electrical bucket shower. And Elliot is really enjoying the warm water. Elliot, skönt!
Say yes! So we are at Stavsro and heading for the summit of Gastatoppen. We are right at the beginning. We took the bus over to here a couple of kilometers, so we are taking the long route up, but it's not so steep. And then we might take the steep route down or take the train down.
Oh, Elliot. Have you got a stone for the cairn? Har du en sten? Elliot thinks we should contribute a little bit to this cairn. Because he thought it was a little bit small, it was not so easy to see. So now it's much better.
Is it heavy?
So, what do you think, Elliot? Is it a nice tour?
En bra tur?
Oh, there, was it a yes or no?
Yes.
Yes? You wanna go like this again? Tomorrow? No? But it's a nice view. Vacker utsikt. Mm. Okay. Ah, fresh.
I think that's the old radio station or something like that. Radio station, I don't know. And the summit is about 500 meters behind there. Now we are gearing up for the last 500 meters. We are at the old military station right now. And the real summit, you can see in the distance, right over there.
So we reached the summit, me and Elliot. Mama had to stay behind. It was not her time this time, so we are picking her up on the way back. But here we are at the top. I think, if you move a little bit, Elliot, that's the marker of the top. And it's actually a little bit higher over there.
And that's the way we came.
The hut where we are staying is, I can't really see in the phone, but it's somewhere over there.
So now we are down from the summit and we are going to take the train down. Thank you. at the cabin again. And I know that someone is happy to take a shower. And someone is very happy to have some electricity. Og så Elliot. Spill.
Hei.
Hei. God natt, Elliot. God natt. And I'm chased out of the bedroom because I snored too much last night. So I have to sleep in the next bedroom this night. So.
So we arrived to today's camp, last camp in Norway, and we picked up some friends along the way, Geir and his girlfriend from Oslo. We left Norway and we are back in Sweden. We just passed Karlstad. We can continue towards Karlsborg. We have to be, we should be in Karlsborg about 1500 hours.